Welcome to Newcastle, to the city centre stadium that is St James's Park. I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith is with me in the commentary position. Premier League football we have for you. It's coming right up. It's Newcastle United, and they take on Watford.
Oh, what an arena we've got here. Perfectly suited to football and two very noisy sets of fans. What a backdrop that should be to what on paper should be an entertaining match.
I don't think there's anyone more likely in the Newcastle United lineup to be the man of the match today than this guy.
There's a lot of quick players about, but it's not always easy to use that speed, but this boy has mastered that to a T.
Newcastle United's lineup. Martin Dubravka is the goalkeeper. Florian Lejeune plays with Federico Fernandez as the centre-backs. Alain Saint-Maximin starts, a midfielder in good form. And a partnership with these two strikers up front. Here's Watford, and this is how they're going to line up. Ben Foster starts in goal. Christian Cabasele plays alongside Adrian Mariappa in the heart of the defence. Etienne Capoue starts, looking to recover his form. And today, it's just the one striker in the side. It could be a special day, this one, for Newcastle United. We'll see. They've got the game underway. Jonjo Shelvey. Now Lingard. Smith. Alain Saint-Maximin, Joe Linton, cut out the pass. Good reading of the play, anticipating the pass. So easy in possession. Credit for trying the shot, Alan.
Well, I've seen him score from those kind of distances, and that's what he had in mind, obviously.
There's a new player in at Inter. You heard it first with us. The signing is complete.
Yeah, and I think both parties will be absolutely delighted. I think he'll have a successful career at his new club, and around £45 million. I think that's money well spent.
Here's Doucouré. Troy Deeney. Ismail Assar. We could be in. That was the chance to go 1-0 up.
And to score this early on, that would have given him so much confidence.
Federico Fernandez. Cher. Jonjo Shelvey. Alain Saint-Maximin. Here's Joe Linton. Made a quick interception. Now Lingard. Found good room out here. Newcastle's chance now. What a fine save. Corner's taken. Proper clearance, well away from the danger zone. He's got some room out here in the wide position.
Left the defenders trailing now. Here's a chance. In the clear in front of goal.
Well, that needed a more subtle touch. He's gone for power and he's nowhere near.
Well, I don't think he kept his head down, actually. Probably thought he'd scored before he'd even hit it.
Lejeune. Pietro Willems. He's got possession back for his team. Plenty of width for the team to attack into. Corner. And here's a possibility of making a chance to go in front.
Well, I'm guessing that he's not going to try that again in a hurry, particularly after his manager gets into him after this match.
Well, here comes the corner. Pressure really on, yet another corner. And in it goes.
Oh, he's kept it out. Rebounds into play off the post. Wonderful defending on the line, stopping the goal. They're coming in at the near post for the cross.
That was catching practice for the goalkeeper.
So close, many to go, weren't they, to take in the lead. Denied by the woodwork. This crowd making their feelings clear. They're demanding a better performance. They know if they keep playing like this, conceding chances like that, they're going to lose this match.
Chance to cross it. Let's pop over to Alan McAnally with news of a goal at the King Power Stadium.
It's a goal for Leicester City.
Saint-Maximin! Fantastic save.
Put the corner in the middle.
Only partially a good save by the keeper.
Well, I don't know if they've come into this match with a wrong attitude, but it's not been their true selves today, not creating anywhere near enough chances, as you can see.
Jonjo Shelvey. 3 minutes, that's what's going to be played for added time. And Maximin. It's Jesse Lingard. Well, that's a bad ball. Here's Joe Linton. Well, we're halfway through and we haven't yet got a goal to bring to you. 0-0 at half-time. Alan, we cannot fault the approach play in this game. It's been excellent, but the finishing...
It's been woeful, hasn't it? Woeful. But on the plus side, you think if it carries on after the break and we get as many chances, we will see some goals.
Referee just checking everything is in order, and he blows for the second half to start. Good safe contact by the goalkeeper to clear it. One or two options now in forward areas for them. And that's what the coach would want, to stop the supply into the middle.
Well, the word average comes to mind about his first half. What do you think, Alan?
He worked hard enough, but just didn't come off for him. But he's got another half to put things right.
Corner swung in. It's under hit the corner, and the man at the front post gets it away.
Federico Fernandez.
As soon as they've lost the ball, they put the high press into operation, and it looks good.
Must take the lead here.
He's blocked that well. Off target. It is going to be a change here, and it looks like a strategic one. Cher.
Federico Fernandez.
Here is Almirón. A quick note for your diary. Excellent movement to get the pass and stay onside.
Race to try and hit it now.
And it's in for Newcastle. You've got to admire the way he placed the ball into the bottom corner of the net.
But the goalkeeper was in a decent position, but he was helpless to stop that one going in. Oh, look at the manager. He works hard on his team on the training ground, and he's seen some reward for it down there now.
So Newcastle United have the lead.
Newcastle United goal, number 12, to Dwight Gayle.
And the away team want to make a change.
Substitution for Watford. Off the
De La Feu. Could get the ball into the box now. Well, they kept up the pressure, didn't they? But it's finally been stopped now.
So how about Watford and the next game, Alan?
Yeah, they're playing Arsenal in the next match. And not much at all to split the two sides for me.
Well, that could be the insurance goal here.
That little bit of daylight that they were after.
He took it with great aplomb. I'm sure getting the first goal gave him the confidence to grab the second chance here. And here is another angle on that goal. Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
United goal! Number 12, to Dwight Gayle.
Holibas. Taking on a couple of opponents now. He's gone for the challenge with a bit of panic written over his face then. Keeper's ball. 20 minutes to go. Dwight Gayle trying a bit too hard, trying to force the pass, and it went straight to an opponent. Holibas. Abdoulaye Doucouré. I think he saw the look from the other player and saw where the pass was going and read it. Alan McAnally's at the Etihad Stadium and he's got news. Threads it through. Now, can he take them on?
Surely he must score!
Lingard. Well, now it looks like a question of just how many. They really are on top now, stretching the lead, looking like the real winners of this match. It's the kind of goal that forwards love, actually, because it rewards their ability to follow in, their anticipation.
Yeah, ends up being a simple-looking goal, but it wasn't. As you say, it was about anticipation. Oh, he's loving it, the manager. He's seeing his team playing really well, just what he was asking for.
Substitute coming on. It's a tactical change.
So off they go again, trying to make some sort of mark in a game that they're being dominated in. It's a big game involving Manchester City. Alan McAnally is reporting on it for us. I'm sorry I had to cut him short. The score is now 5-1. I see a substitute coming on for the away team here. Mariappa. Jose Holibas. Impressive in possession. Passing's good, possibly dangerous.
It's not really away. Poor clearance.
We've got 8 more minutes of the 90. Three-nil now, almost over, and this should have a good impact on the next game, Alan.
Trying to slip it through. And shoots! Oh, it's off the bar! Good defensive clearance there.
Yeah, he's so close with that one. Fine margins in this match.
And that ball belongs to the goalkeeper.
That's a dreadful error.
Give a round of applause for today's...
Looking for goal now. Tried to keep it down, but couldn't.
If he had it, I think the keeper might have been struggling there.
Substitution for Watford coming off the pitch. Number 19.
There's some movement in the dugout. Going to get a change here.
Number 8, Tom Clay.
He's had a good look and decided what he's seen from this period of play to add on 3 minutes. Promising forward play from them again.
A bright idea, but he couldn't manufacture the pass that would have got his teammate away and in on goal. And it's come to an end now as the referee calls a halt.
Well, you don't have to dominate the football to win the match. This is a perfect example of it.
No, there were times when they sat off, they allowed the opposition to have the ball, but really didn't counter-attack well.
Well, undoubtedly, he was the star man today.
So often we think of his creative abilities, that knack of picking out a pass, but today it was all about his finishing. A really good couple of goals in this team win.
Left the defenders trailing now. Here's a chance.
Just a couple of questions for you. Thanks, that'll be all for today.